nowadays, passwords are required to be more and more complex. That is for the right reason. It is all too easy for a determined hacker to run a brute force attack on a website in order to steal someone's passwords, especially if it is shorter. We have evolved from plain text password storage to hashing a password to appending salts, and now even this is not considered adequate anymore. Today, let us find out how software giants like Facebook or Google stores user passwords. Before we move on, if you haven't subscribed to this channel yet, feel free to subscribe and turn on notifications to continue watching more tech-related videos from TechReview. Whenever we create a new account in Google or Facebook, they ask few informations like username, email address or phone number, date of birth, gender, and the most sensitive stuff, the password. Once you enter all these informations and create a new account, these informations will go into the service provider's user information database, where all the informations except the password are saved in the form of plain text. The passwords are hashed with very complicated algorithms. Hashing is a method of cryptography that converts any form of data into a unique string of text. It is a mathematical operation that is easy to perform but extremely difficult to reverse. The difference between hashing and encryption is that encryption can be reversed or decrypted using a specific key, whereas reversing hash data is a mammoth task. Most widely used hashing functions are MD5, SHA1 and SHA-256. Some hashing processes are significantly harder to crack than others. One major drawback of hashing is even though they cannot be deciphered using algorithms, some easy passwords can be cracked using rainbow tables. Rainbow tables is a precomputed table for reversing cryptographic hash functions, usually for cracking password hashes. But they contain the password hashes of only the passwords which are commonly used. Highly secure service providers like Google and Facebook use additional security features like salt and pepper. A salt is a non-secret unique value in the database which is added to the password before it gets hashed. Adding salt between the user-defined password makes the passwords very strong and very difficult to identify using rainbow tables. A pepper is a secret value or a key which is used to turn the hash into a keyed hashing for message authentication. Once a pepper is added to the password cannot be reconstructed without a key. This could increase the security if an attacker would only have access to the database and not to the place where the key is actually stored. Now, if you ask me, does Facebook or Google know their users' passwords? With all these cryptographic features added to the passwords, the only information about password which is saved in the user information database of Google or Facebook is a heavily hashed data from which it is highly impossible to get the information about the passwords. Not only Google or Facebook, most of the reliable service providers won't store plain text passwords anymore. A big advice to the TechReveal viewers is that never take passwords strung lightly. Always make a password which is strong enough even without salt and peppers. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please give a thumbs up and leave your thoughts about password safety in the comment box. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.